Boy Meets, it's Dazzling Latte, and welcome to Faith. Okay, so it's supposed to be like a DOS-style horror game, so let's begin. It's a little bit cropped out too much because, like, I accidentally, like, the window's really big. Anyways, we can see most of it. Okay, so I'm loving it so far. I love the old, like, DOS games. Can I walk faster? Okay, so this is... Oh my gosh. Can I interact with it? How do I... Oh no! I don't know how to play! One second. Okay, so I'm back. Space! Okay, am I like an exorcist or something? You're invited. Come celebrate Nate and Jason's 6th birthday, Saturday, May 3rd, 12 p.m. to 4 p.m. Directions, turn right at 1338 Snake Meadow Hill Road. It goes straight past the well. Okay, cool. Okay, so straight past the well. So we keep just going. We just keep going. Oh my gosh, those little things scare me. Ah, I'm gonna die. Are you kidding me? Man, I thought I was gonna start like playing funeral music, like dun, 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 dun. I think that might be like for like a Dracula movie. I don't know. Anyway, so we're starting all over again because I mistakenly ran the wrong way from a spider. It's gonna be a lot of editing on this because I will not make you sit through all this. Oh my gosh. We die from this, don't we? No, we don't. Okay. Well, it's just scared off my only friend. Oh my gosh, there's so many deer. Honestly, I don't think they should be around this area.
Why?
Like, hold the cross up when the giant demon spider comes at me. I think I'm supposed to. I love this. It's so cool. I love, like, games in the style of, like, classic video games. I really love that. Like, I know it's, like, all about all the graphics, but I don't know. Just sometimes it feels nice to play something from, like, an older time. You know? Like, to feel like you're playing something from, like, the 80s or 90s. I think this would be like more 80s. I swear, I'm so lucky in this run. Oh my gosh. That's gonna be the thumbnail for the video. It's like right there. Right there. That's the thumbnail for part one. It's like... Oh. Can I unlock it? The power of religion. No, I actually am kind of religious. So, do I go back, like, around the back of the house? Wait, do I use the invitation? Because I don't see any other way of getting in.
Let me in.
I mean, honestly, I'm not, like, a bad person. Just, like, let me in. Let me in. Oh my gosh, oh my gosh. Yeah, no, that doesn't help. Oh, Mr. Barton, it has taken longer than expected registering the markers on your property. Markers on your property is a historical cemetery. Our office has had difficulty identifying who was buried there. The inscriptions on the gravestones are written in a language that we cannot identify. have sent the gravestone rubbings to some of my peers at the University of Connecticut. I will reach out to you when I get a response from them. Okay. No. 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 Okay. I'll be back. Okay, I'm back. Apparently it just like locked up.
No.
Oh yeah. So the house is locked, so we need to find another way in. Oh, what is this? That's how you can get them to go away. You can get them to go away. Oh my gosh. Well, that's... Yes. Yes. Like, I thought if one of those spiders shows up, you're just screwed. But you're not. Okay, so I feel more comfortable exploring now that I have that knowledge. Scouse me. Oh, am I supposed to like hold it up and point it at the spider? Okay. Well, let's do this again. Again. Why? Why? Okay, so you do have to aim it at the spider. Oh my gosh, that deer scared the crap out of me. I thought it was another spider. I know another one's gonna come up because they're just assholes. I have a feeling, yes. Oh yeah. Yeah, you better run. Let's see if we can make it to the house without dying this time. No, no. No. You ass. No. I feel like when you're ready for the spiders, they don't come. Oh my gosh, I know one's coming. I know one's coming. I can feel it. I can feel it. I can feel it. I can feel it. I told you. No, you're not getting me. Today I noticed Amy's favorite tree looks like it's dying. All the needles are falling off it and the bark is peeling. I guess I'm more upset about it than Amy is. She is totally absorbed in her volunteer work at the clinic. I guess it's good that she found something she's passionate about, but I've gotten ugly looks from some of the women at book club. Kathy and her religious friends won't even talk to me anymore. Why? Because she's like volunteering somewhere, like charity is like awful. What is this? Chaos reigns. I don't have a good feeling about going up, so we're gonna do that. I don't know why I should go right. Oh, poop my pipe. Poop, 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 poop. I knew you were coming. Sorry for anybody who's pooped their pants while watching this. Oh gosh, this music is so ominous. Oh my gosh. Oh hey, it's another thing. Public lecture by Carl James Osborne. Connecticut's historical connections, witchcraft, Satanism, and the beast system. Not bee system. Beast system. Wednesday at 8 p.m. Okay. Oh my gosh. We're making progress. Oh. Okay, so we spread. gosh, we scrolled down, we scrolled down. Okay, so that wasn't a glitch in the game. Barton's house lies about 100 yards off the Snake Meadow Hill Road. There's almost no driveway. Trees jut out in the middle of a gravel path that is mostly covered in grass. It was difficult to find the house, especially since it was already dark when we arrived. Father Elred, seemed to know where he was going. He simply drove straight ahead until we arrived at the house. In the headlights, I saw an old shed off to the right of the path. Father Elred explained that he would rather perform the exorcism away from the house, but the Martins had insisted that Amy remain inside. He complained that having family present makes it difficult to proceed with the elements of the rite that may seem harsh to the lay person.
Okay. Oh, my butthole just clenched.
Oh, yeah, I knew you were coming. Oh, my gosh, yeah. Okay, so we gotta go back. We're just running on adrenaline. I look so crazy. I just looked at myself. No. Oh my gosh, yes, queen. Okay, we got the key. Oh, you're not gonna mess this up for me now. No, honey.
Oh my gosh.
Greeted us at the front porch. Mr. Martin led us downstairs to the basement, explaining that Amy was down there in restraints. I felt for him. There was guilt and shame in his voice. Amy was in the very back of the attic. What? Amy was in the very back of the attic in a chair, perfectly calm, staring at us. It is hard to describe the look on her face. It was not the kind of look a child gives you. Okay, so I need to mentally prepare myself before pressing enter.
Okay. There's a reason why it saves just as you're walking into the house.
Okay, so I guess we go upstairs? Because it's at the attic. That looks like a closet. That looks like something I might need.
Oh gosh. I need the poop.
Okay. I don't know, just have a feeling. I'm going by instinct. What is that? Bob must be stationed somewhere in the Middle East because he sent over this weird looking doll for Amy's birthday.
No.
I'll ask Anish about it next time we have book club. She looks like she could be from over there. Amy didn't seem excited to see the doll. I think she would rather have a phone instead. Or maybe seeing a baby doll makes her feel self-conscious about working at the clinic. I guess I was the only one who thought to check in the attic. When I got up there, it was freezing cold. I found Amy standing in the back, looking straight at me like when I first met her downstairs.
We spoke briefly, although it was frustrating to talk to her or it. I experienced a bit of deception from the demon. During our conversation, she uttered my mother's first name and in other instances spoke perfect Latin. I called for help from the others, but nobody came, so I raised my crucifix and began the rite again. Okay, so is this like his diary or something? There's journal pages, like, I have no idea. Like, who are we playing as? Oh no. No. I have a feeling I've played this game before. I don't know, one of these toys is gonna go off. And I'm gonna poop myself. Like, the Etch-a-Sketch is gonna start dancing. Oh, okay. We're already, back around to here. What's this? Okay, I'm guessing we, like, go downstairs, because there's nothing, there's no attic. I don't see an attic. Ugh. Okay, so I think it's in the basement that we need to go. Attics and basements are, like, the creepiest things ever. I can't tell if Amy's, like, the daughter. That's fine. I don't know why I keep holding up the cross to the plants, but I don't know. I know I've seen a trailer for this game. Ugh. That isn't the creepiest thing ever. There's like a shadow behind me. There's something behind me. I think I held up the cross to like the jacket and everything. Like, it's like everything. You never know what's gonna pop out at ya. Oh my gosh, that mannequin. Why do there have to be mannequins? Who keeps mannequins in the basement? Is there a sheet? Is there a gate? I just feel safe when these come up because it's like a lot of reading and nothing's gonna pop out at you. Dear Amy, thanks for writing. It really brightened my day hearing from you. In your letter, you asked, what's the weirdest thing I've seen as a missionary? The area we are working in has a lot of folks who practice Quimbamba. It's what you might call a pagan religion. Ooh. It's kind of a mix of Catholic and African religions. One of the saints they worship is San La Morte, or Saint Death. Yesterday, we talked to a boy about 15. When we asked him if he had ever prayed, he said, no, but I have prayed to San La Morte. He's told us about a time when he stayed over at his cousin's house, and according to him, they prayed to some figures of San La Morte, and the figures made things in the house move around. That is so creepy. He got real quiet and scared looking after that. We told him we could pray to God and that God wouldn't make him feel scared like that. We invited him to church, but he hasn't come yet. I need to wrap this letter up and get back to work. See you in 4 months, Layton. Oh, hell no. One of these little things is gonna move. Oh gosh. I think it's the one up above, because that one looks different from the rest. So it's none of these. Okay, I'm getting out of here. I don't like this. I don't like this room. I'm going back. I'm going down.
Amy's parents could not endure witnessing the proceedings of the rite for long. Mrs. Martin was hysterical, and the thing that was inside Amy was feeding off the fear. Father Elred asked me to take the Martins upstairs. I was physically worn out, but managed to get them back up the stairs into the kitchen. Amy was screaming, "Mother, Mother," the whole time. I finally got them to sit down with me at the kitchen table. After a few minutes, we couldn't hear much of anything down there and down in the basement. So I went down to check on things. I found Father Elred lying on his back, unconscious, with his arms spread out wide. Amy was not in the chair.
Oh no. Oh no.
She just loves there's not a chair, there's just a candle. Oh, hell no. I'm pressing the space bar. Well, that was fun. Okay, we know the bathroom's the first place because you hear the. No. Downstairs, 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 downstairs. You poop, you little poop. Do we have to, like, get back down to the basement? Do I have to get to the attic? Where do I have to get? Okay, so I'm back. I have no idea what's going on. Oh my gosh, I gotta turn this back down. So I did look up a walkthrough, but it was kind of no help. So I have no idea what I'm supposed to be doing. No! Do I, like, just have to defeat her in every single one? One down. Many to go. Up. No. There's no more shadow. Oh, are you... Okay, I think I have to go to the shed. There's this. This is one I forgot to read. Okay. Mr. Martin, it has taken longer than expected registering the make mark. Okay, yeah, we've already. All the best, Daryl Henderson, State of Connecticut Historical Society. We already read all of that. Okay, so I haven't been reading all the notes. Okay, Bob, the kids and I miss you more every day. The twins and Amy have started their next school year here at home. Amy keeps asking when she's going to be allowed to go to real school. I think she's getting cabin fever. The twins are having no problems occupying their time. Yesterday they came in with their hands covered in blood. They found a dead
birthday party. Can't wait till you come home. Oh my gosh. I can't believe I found this again. Can I just go back to my car? Father Garcia, you were hereby instructed to release Michael Davies from your care and return him to his home immediately. Mr. and Mrs. Davies have already been contacted by our office. A representative of the church is currently en route to their home to discuss compensation in return for their discretion. You will meet our representative there and accompany him back to Rome. Cardinal Gifford. Huh. Please just let me get my car and drive away. Okay, we're just gonna walk along the road. Probably gonna get hit by something. I don't care. There's something down there. That asshole. Aw, oh, poop. Why isn't it open? It pisses me off that everybody else is so good at video games. Oh, I know what to do. I know what to do. I don't. I did it. You know, this makes me feel good. I'm actually stuck with a video game. Sometimes I just get really frustrated and I quit, but this one, I kept going because I really like the art style of it. It's spooky, but it's like, I love DOS games. They're just so cool. Karen. The church might contact you in a few days to tell you their version of what happened to me. I want you to hear it from me first. A year ago, I was involved in the exorcism of Amy Martin. What they said in the papers about what happened isn't true. She, my superior father, when I confronted her, she managed to cut the power to the house and her own parents with their own. I have to go back to that house. The nightmares I'm having are real. She's still there waiting for me. I can still help her. If I don't come back, know that I love you and I'm sorry. John. Oh. Oh no. What's that little leaf? Why does that one have a face? No. No. No.
My God, what happened to you? Do you feel my face is breaking? I have to fix.
happens next? Oh my gosh. That was such a panic attack. I can't believe I made it to here. So I have to go back to the house to grab that? Seems a little weird. It's not letting me do anything else. Unless I just, like, stand and aim the cross at her for, like, an extended period of time. I'm gonna try that. I don't have a feeling that that's the good ending. But, like, there's nothing else I can do. Something doesn't seem right. Ugh. And I guess we'd go back? Seems like a pretty morbid ending. Oh my gosh. She's not there anymore. It is so quiet. Guess I'll go back to the car now. Something really doesn't feel right about this ending. There's no deer around. There's no little spider things. Game over. Ending 1 of 5, murderer.
I told you.
That ending didn't seem right.
Police arrest man accused of murdering missing girl. A New York man is in custody after he confessed to the murder of a Sterling girl who had been missing. John Ward of Palmyra was pulled over on Snake Meadow Hill Road last night after a state trooper reported hearing a gunshot. The officer thought it might be poachers. The officer said Ward was acting nervous and suspicious after being pulled over. When questioned, Ward reportedly said, I've killed her. According to the police reports, the officer called for backup after Ward became increasingly upset, saying repeatedly that there was a demon inside her. Ward was taken to Sterling Police Headquarters for further questioning. Ward then confessed to authorities that he shot and killed Amy Martin, a 17-year-old girl who had been missing for 9 days after escaping a mental institution. After a brief search, police located Amy's body and was near the now-abandoned Martin home. In addition to receiving a gunshot wound to the stomach, Amy showed injuries suggesting that she had been thrown out of the second story window of the house. An officer who helped recover the body told reporters that Amy's face had been mutilated in a very brutal manner. Ward was found dressed as a priest when he was pulled over. It is suspected that he impersonated a priest to gain his victim's trust after Catholic authorities in Rome confirmed that Ward was not an ordained minister.
The rest of the article is missing.
Okay, so I'm thinking
that's going to be the end. I don't know how to get the other ending, so that's the only ending I got. So I hope you enjoyed this. This is going to take a long-ass time to edit. Like, this. There's probably like 2 hours worth of footage. But I had fun playing it, and I think it'll be a really good video. Like, I think it'll be pretty funny. We'll have some scary moments and stuff, and some really serious moments at the end. Like, I don't know how I get the bad endings always. I can't think of any other thing that I would do. Like, I tried everything. So, for now I have to go, but until then, swim silly, DQ, and your pirate crew.